I am directed to refer to this department's notification dated 26/2/1983, endorsed to you YD even number dated 1/1/1983, on the subject noted above, full stop. A question had arisen as to whether a civil servant on his appointment on acting charge, current charge basis can be presumed to have assumed full duties and responsibilities of the post to which he is appointed and can exercise all statutory, financial and administrative powers vested in regular incumbent of the post, full stop. The full salary of the post to which he is appointed, expect in case of acting or current charge arrangements for which a separate manner of payment of emoluments has been prescribed by the finance department, full stop. When a person is allowed full benefits of a post, he is expected to perform all duties and responsibilities of the same, full stop. Exercise of statutory, administrative or financial power is in fact the most important responsibility, and a person holding a post should be bound to undertake this responsibility, full stop. In view of the above position, it has been decided in consultation with law and finance departments that a civil servant's on his appointment to a post on acting charge or current charge basis shall assume full duties and responsibilities of the post and can exercise all statutory, administrative and financial powers vested in a regular or permanent incumbent of that post, full stop. I am directed to refer to this department's circular letter of even number dated 3/11/1997 on the subject noted above, wherein attention was invited to the observation made by the Supreme Court of Pakistan in Civil Appeals number and 188-2 that continuance of acting charge or current charge appointments for a number of years is negation of the spirit of rules, full stop. It was, therefore, desired that where such appointments are made in public interest, these should not continue indefinitely and every effort be made to fill in such posts through regular appointment in shortest possible time, full stop. Accountant General, Punjab, has reported that the above instructions are not being followed by the appointing authorities while making appointments are being made against the same posts after a gap of 1 or 2 days, which is against the provision of Rule 10B, IBID, and need to be regularized with the approval of the competent authority, full stop. The above position was further highlighted in the meeting held in the Establishment Division on 7/8/1995, which was also attended by the provincial government's representative in order to emphasize the negative aspects of shoulder promotion besides the irregularity aspects, especially in view of the increasing trend among the provincial governments to resort to the posting of junior officers against higher post, full stop. In order to ensure proper compliance of these instructions, the Auditor General of Pakistan is also being requested to direct the Accountants General of the respective provinces not to issue last pay certificate in cases of shoulder promotion notification unless the establishment division's prior clearance has been obtained full stop. The provincial governments are once again advised that instructions contained in this division's above referred OM may be strictly observed while considering appointments to higher posts and to avoid making shoulder promotions full stop. It must be ensured that in the case of police officers, they are not allowed to wear higher ranks unless their promotions are duly notified by the establishment division full stop.
Okay.